Well, the play is amazing. The play is a masterpiece. So if you don't know the play, just for the play, you have to come. And the fact that we're doing it half in English and half in French, it gives a very modern vision, especially for us, for the French audience, because it's such a famous play in France. We are so used to see different version. But this mix is really, really new, and the play becomes really eternal in a way. And it's exciting, I mean, to switch all the time from one language to another one. And I think the show is beautiful, which is already, I mean, in terms of picture, I haven't seen it, but I kind of feel it's beautiful, no?
It's also very political, and I think there's some very explicit references in the production. How do you feel audiences will respond to that? Because often art referencing modern day politics, for example, can be quite divisive.
Yeah, Christopher Hampton wanted really to put the story in nowadays perspective. So, yeah, the references are super clear. So for us, for the French team at the beginning, it was, you don't touch to Molière. But in fact, it's really, really interesting. But we didn't know how the audience would react, and they laugh a lot. And now I'm wondering, do the French would laugh that much? I don't know. But I think English people are super anti-Trump. So it's a kind of cathartic to laugh about it, I think.
Can you talk a little bit about what makes Paul such a wonderful fit for that role?
Yeah, he's an animal in a wonderful way. And you know, actors, we are animals. In a second, we sniff each other and we see if it's gonna work or not. And after a few minutes, I could see that I will enjoy working with him, because he's charming and clever and dangerous and sexy, and it's much more physical than all the other Tartuffe I already seen. And yeah, I like working with him because we're changing every day. It's not completely blocked. We have these possibilities to reinvent every night the story we want to say. And I really like it.
Rare to see bilingual, truly bilingual productions. What do you think that gives both the story and the audience they perhaps don't get from other productions that maybe haven't taken that route?
I don't know, actually, because myself, I never saw a show in bilingual version. I mean, I've already saw show in a foreign language, but you used to read. I mean, after 5 minutes, you manage to watch and read. This is more tricky because you have to switch and, you know, read and watch. So actually, I can't reply. I mean, I don't know how, but tonight, I mean, the audience, they seem really happy. So I think it works. I think it's playful. It's playful. After 5 minutes, I think you enter in the, it's part of the deal. So, but I don't know if it's difficult or no, actually, because I'm not in the audience, so I have to ask, actually.
What does it mean for you to be performing here in the heart of the West End?
It's a huge challenge, and for me, it's like a dream, actually. I never really fantasized about working here. And so when they offered me the part, I was, yeah, that's exactly what I want to do right now in my career. So I'm super happy.